Welcome back. As we earlier said, that August 12th of every year marks International Youth Day. And of course, this special day marks a very very special occasion to Egyptians, because the Egyptian leadership have been concerned about the rights and the upbringing, the upgrading, the empowering, the enforcement of Egyptian youth according to directives of President Abdel Fattah Sisi. Celebrating that special day, President Abdel Fattah Sisi yesterday have tweeted saying that he gives special concern to Egyptian youth, and he has taken 2016 as the year of youth. He also expressed how he felt about youth, as they represented to him half of the present and the whole future. That was a very, very impulsive, very impressive tweet by President al-Sisi. Of course, he expressed also his full confidence in the Egyptian young capabilities and determination to contribute to achieving the dreams and aspirations of the nation. And we're very delighted to be having with us live over the phone Dr. Maha Mahgoub. She's a life coach and a human development expert. Good morning, Dr. Mahgoub. How are you doing?
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you so much. And yeah, of course, we, President Abdel Fattah Sisi, as we all know, he is a person, one of the very rare people and presidents and leaders of the nation who came to stretch out his hands to youth and give them the break of their lives. How do you see that phrase?
Yes, of course, yes. In celebration of the International Day worldwide, President Sisi has absolute confidence in the youth of Egypt, and their enthusiasm and determination is that our original dream of building a homeland of glory, pride, and dignity has been achieved. He believes very well the importance of youth, as they are representing about 60% of the total population of Egypt, and the state depends on them in modern development plans. And of course, from this prospect, he emphasized or stressed on youth empowerment, which is the word he would like, a dream in Egypt. Until the president of the Fattah Sisi assumed the power in 2014 and put youth in their assuming office top of his priorities, and that was evident in Egypt and state taking several steps towards the goal of levels of achieving the presidential goal. And of course, since that time, a lot of achievements have been occurred with youth for youth empowerment, such as assessing the leadership position to youth. And just President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi assuming the presidency of Republic, practical steps have emerged in integrating youth into various occasions. He said a lot of deputy ministers, about 23 deputy of ministers, as well governors, two of them are governors. Maybe he has assigned 23 deputy of governors and two governors, and assistant, as well assisting system in prime minister. The cabinet approved it during the meeting on February 12, 2020, headed by Dr. Mustafa Madbouli, the draft of a resolution of system assistance in prime minister. And a lot of initiatives have been accorded for youth empowerment.
That's very good. And continuing or building on what you are saying, Dr. Mahgoub, that the Egyptian administration is giving all in its hands to empower and enforce the youth. Taking a closer look or a comprehensive look over the situation of youth 7 years back, youth have come a long way after even more than 30 or more years struggling and to achieve rights, struggling to prove themselves, struggling to attain facilities and things, and these were went in air. They found no one to stretch their hands to. But ever since the Egyptian current Egyptian administration has been in effect, and President Abdel Fattah Sisi have been taking office, he has given special concern to the empowerment of youth. How was that put into reality? I mean, what are the changes that have been effected over that particular sector in society, about the youth sector?
Yes, of course. Since the 26th of the January Revolution, the present city and most of people realized the importance of youth. As I mentioned, that they are representing more than 60% of the Egyptian population. Therefore, the main strategy of youth empowerment was the main objective of the present city concern. For example, he has held a lot of conferences for youth empowerment as a national dialogue between youth and Egyptian people. He established National Academy for building the human being as nation advances through the youth, and a lot of initiatives for youth empowerment. For example, he has empowered the youth in several aspects. Maybe, for example, if we talk about the economic empowerment, he has launched the facilitating the project of youth taxes and food transport distribution for vehicles. The project of 1.5 million fed dan project, giving each young man the opportunity to obtain 10 fed dan in installments at 5% interest rate. And of course, he facilitated access to finance by giving low interest at 5%, as well he encouraged the entrepreneurship all over the region, not only in Egypt, but it looks like he created Egypt, as a national hub for the region, for providing the first the center for providing entrepreneurship in Egypt, supporting and accelerating business for young people. He launched an initiative for training for 10,000 youth, Egyptian and African youth, all over the African continent. As well, for example, if we talk about entrepreneurship, he instructed to establish a center which is your idea is your company, for supporting entrepreneurship. And in last 1 year, they presented about 450 sessions how to monitor and to guide young entrepreneurs for establishing their business. As well, I would like to mention something very important. Just he empowered youth in the political issues. As in the new constitutions, he has allocated 25% of seats for youth and 30% for women. And therefore, he has appointed about 28 youth as parliament members, and two of them in youth council.
Right.
So, yes, a lot of initiatives have been supported the Egyptian youth since 6 years of the present city.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Dr.
Maha Mahgoub, the human development expert and the life coach, would like to thank you so much for this phone call, and you have a beautiful day. Thank you so
much. Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you.
And I guess with this, we come to the end of this edition of The Breakfast Show. Many thanks to all of you. Until we see you once again tomorrow morning, that's a goodbye.